All right, guys, I've been jamming to Foo Fighters because I didn't get to see them live at CES, but I've been using the brand new Audio-Technica ATH-M50X-BT. These are the Bluetooth versions of the very famous ATH-M50X headphones. I've got a pair on the headphone wall. I reviewed them years ago. I mean, these headphones are old, and there's now a Bluetooth version. And first thing I'll say, it's exactly like the old headphones, which is not a bad thing. Those headphones are really good. Now, I've got the special edition version with the blue and the brown leather, which really looks nice. And I wish it came in that color variant for this. I've got a black one here. The headphones are good. They're good. They remind me of Audio-Technica, but it also shows some of the deficiencies that they have right now in the very recent climate of headphones. So what do we have with the M50X BT. A couple of things. So they run 45mm neodymium drivers. They are really good drivers. So, like I said, I was listening to Foo Fighters, which doesn't match my dancing and all that stuff early on. But what they do is they drive that kind of music really well. So you've got, you know, some nice, your highs are actually pretty good on this. Your mids really drive well. You know, these have really solid good mids, and the lows also drive really well on these headphones. So the drivers do a really good job there. Now, of course, this supports aptX codecs as well, so you're getting some nice clean audio. Now, in reference for people who don't understand why I always say it's great to have a pair of headphones that have aptX or aptX HD, it's because they drive closer to CD quality, because your MP3s, your streaming content doesn't match the high quality music. And you're wondering, what is that? It means that you can hear the syllables, the sounds, the different instruments, the different changes in instruments, and the vocal disparity that the artist you're listening to gives. And that's what that does. So for me, it does a really good job on these pair of headphones. And it closely matches when you're plugged in wired. Again, because the drivers are the same, the tuning is very similar. If I plug this in, which of course it comes with a USB cable to charge, as well as a lightning cable, you're getting that very same ATH-M50X sound quality, which is good. It's of course, like I said, for me, wireless and wired, it's not there yet. But that being said, it does a really good job. Now, you're asking, noise cancellation? No, it doesn't. Took a couple of rides on the subway, and you could definitely hear everything. You have to crank the volume loud. That's one of my biggest gripes here, is that the volume balance, because it's not a noise isolation ear cups, don't really help with you. So you've got to crank it higher to hear around all that noise. But if you're, say, at home, or you're walking on a quieter street, you're fine. You're fine with these headphones. That's something I wish they included in this. Now, it's priced at $199. Comes with a carrying pouch, as well as also a cable for charging, as I mentioned earlier, which is micro USB, which, I'm sorry, if you're releasing this late 2018, as you did on Audio-Technica, should have been USB Type-C. I'm sorry, I just can't accept that. So it's been a really annoying charging this, because it takes 7 hours to fully charge. Now, battery life is about 40 hours or so, which is good. Does a really good job on battery life. And of course, you know, connecting it to devices is really easy. There's that switch button for, you know, Bluetooth on and off. Very nice, simple. Now, the volume controls and the playback controls are buttons. And you know what? I think I'm not a fan of that anymore. I think it was nice and easy to do that, especially on the left ear cup. But I wish it was closer around the side of the ear cup, and not on the side, and not underneath the panels, because it's harder to access there. You're trying to find, okay, which is volume up, which is volume down, which is like my play and pause, rather than it just being tapping on the side, or using touch controls, or having just really big buttons on the side there would be easier for me to navigate. So that aspect I do not like. But when it comes to sound quality, as I mentioned, it does a really good job, because the sound driver signature is similar to what you have with the original M50s from Audio Technica, which are great pair of headphones. They're more bassy than my standard approach, but I think a lot of people like this, and a lot of people like headphones that can do your highs, mids, lows well, plus still provide a nice bass range to actually fill in terms of you listening to, you know, trap music, you're listening to some techno, some house, anything that bass heavy. What it does do well, it doesn't add extra bass in songs that don't. So I was listening to some Nigerian music, you know, some Davido, P Square, and those came out pretty well. There's not a lot of bass in there, but there's a lot of, like, you know, nice highs and lows that come up from the sound. So now my your question is, would I recommend these? I would say yes. I think they're very good, especially if you're not looking for a pair of noise canceling headphones. They're $199. I would not charge that price though. I think they should be about $150, maybe $169 for these headphones, because they are basically a rehash of something that's about 4 years old, just adding Bluetooth, let's be real. So for me, that's where I think the pricing is just a little off, but I do like what they bring to the table. I do like the sound quality because it's similar to what they have standard. So there you have it, guys. That is the Audio Technica ATH M50X BT, Bluetooth version of one of their famous pair of headphones. The other thing I'll mention is Audio Technica design-wise, I almost forgot about this, comfort. They're comfortable for me, but you need to adjust the positioning, which can be annoying. And I think, you know what, we're in a day and age where people want more comfortable headphones. This design just doesn't fit that well. And that's something hopefully they can do with the M60s or an M70 in the future. So if you have any questions or any comments, let me know, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video, favorite this video, subscribe to the channel, and always enjoy your entertainment. Time for more Foo Fighters. Which would you rather, a punch hole or a notch? And the giveaway here is simply this. Head over to Instagram, go ahead and like this photo, basically the photo you see on screen on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram if you've not followed me already, and then tag a friend and you're entered to win. I'll run the giveaway for about a week and I'll announce the winners right here on YouTube and also on Instagram as well. So remember, head over there, like this photo, tag a friend, and follow me on Instagram.